Which brands is Pentland Brands best known for?
So we own a number of brands and we license others. One of the main ones that we own is Speedo Swimwear, the world's number one swimwear brand. Also Canterbury, the rugby brand. Berghaus in the outdoors, Mitre in football. And then we're involved in licensing a number of fantastic brands like Lacoste and Ted Baker for footwear.
And you were explaining in your panel session that the company has a long and interesting family history, doesn't it? How far does it go back?
So I'm third generation. The business was started 82 years ago by my grandfather with a single shoe shop in Liverpool in the Northwest. So it's great to have continued the family ownership. And my boss is also my father as our chairman. So we currently have two generations involved and looking forward to the fourth generation of the family coming into the business.
And am I right in saying you're in almost every country in the world?
We are in almost 200 countries, so we're in all.
There are only almost 200 countries in the world.
At the last Olympics, there was about 220 countries competing, so there are probably a few small islands that we're not yet in. We might be able to sell a few pairs of Speedos, but we're in most of the major markets.
So what have you learned about breaking into new markets over the years?
So our business model is working through distribution partners in most markets around the world. So finding and selecting the right partner is absolutely key for us. So working with partner organizations, either the CBI or UKTI, identifying and finding the best companies in each country to work with that think in the same way as we do and share our long-term ambition is absolutely crucial.
When you're already spread so widely around the world, what potential is there left for you?
There's lots of potential because in many of the main developed markets, there are a number of our brands that aren't yet penetrating to a significant extent. So in terms of growing market share, we've still got a long way to go.
Where are your biggest growth markets right now?
So in the developed world, we've still got a long way to go in the US. We're growing very well in most of the major European countries, but the fastest growth is in Asia Pacific and specifically in China, where we've had phenomenal growth over the last couple of years.
How difficult has that been in China?
It's taken us a while. It's taken us time to find an appropriate business model, to identify the right positioning, and very importantly in our business in sports and fashion, making sure that our product is appropriate to the local consumer who may be different from how we see consumers in the European market.
So if I went and looked at the products you sell over there, would I notice differences compared with what you're selling in the UK?
So in most of our brands, there's a core collection that can be consistent, but there then will be local differences because whether it's color, print, or body shape, there are things that do make a difference locally.
And what would you say to anybody listening, businesses listening, who are trying to do what you've done and break into foreign markets?
Take your time, research the market, get to meet lots of different people, take references, and very importantly, don't try and do it by remote control. You've got to be in the market. And when you appoint a partner, you've got to work closely with them so they understand your brand strategy and your brand DNA rather than reinterpret it themselves.